Hi, it's Kendra. I'm going to talk you through a wet and wet underpainting I did for a mountain scene. First, I wet the paper back and forth with a goat hair brush. I wanted it to be even and shiny, not drippy. I mixed together DaVinci vermilion with ultramarine blue and created a spectrum from the orange to the blue so that I'd have all the colors in between to choose from. I also added in a bit of rose madder genuine, and I just swept the colors across the sky. And you can see that I'm grabbing from the orange, from the orangey blue to the bluey gray, all the colors in between. And I've mixed some of the rose madder into my ultramarine as well so that I have sort of a purpley gray as well. At the bottom, I'm sweeping some of the shadows that might appear on the mountains in the foreground, and it's just supposed to be soft, like an underpainting. It's not meant to be the actual shadows, which I will paint later wet on dry. I wanted some dramatic clouds, so I kept dropping in more color, and I don't normally play that much in a wet and wet sky. I normally like to use as few brushstrokes as possible, but this time I was really playing, really going for it, and I just kept dabbing in more color, and then it got quite crazy, and it looked a little bit scribbly, so I used my brush to lift out some of the paint. And then I started dabbing in some pure water in the sky to push back some pigment and make some white splotches. But I realized those are going to make big blossoms. So I took my spray bottle and I just sprayed the whole top of the painting and tried to move it towards the top right corner. Then I let it dry. I realized my mistake because, as you're going to see, a great big blossom formed along the bottom one third of my paper. And I could have avoided that if I would have also sprayed the bottom of my paper, because if everything had been evenly wet, then I would have avoided the blossom. But as it was, because the bottom was more dry than the top, they butt up against each other, and the wet wants to move as far as it can into the damp paint, but the damp paint resists it and can't accept it, so it causes that hard line to form. Luckily, I was able to overcome the blossom by incorporating it into my painting, and it became the hills in the foreground of my mountain landscape. I made a time-lapse video of the entire painting, so if you'd like to see how this turned out, jump on over there and check it out. Thanks so much for joining me, and I'd love it if you subscribe.